Alright, folks, welcome to today's contest between your Reading D squad. We are out in Leominster, cold morning this morning, against the North Middlesex. I'd have to check their name. I don't know what their name is. Do you know? The North Middlesex Cowboys, John just informed me. So it's the North Middlesex Cowboys. Should be a good day today, nice and sunny, playing on a nice grass field, which is good. Your captains for today are number 8, Rocco Masciarelli, and number 71, Colin Donahue. The Rockets enter this game 0-5, looking for their first win, which I think this team is pretty pumped up to do today. And it should be a real good game, so we'll be back with kickoff. All right, the Cowboys are set to kick off. Got number 7, Brendan Lindmark, and number 3, Braden Nowicki, back deep. The kick is underway. The ball is bouncing around a little bit. Lindmark is going to pick it up, take it. He's looking for some room. He breaks one tackle and finally met behind the line of scrimmage. Pushed back where the Rockets will take over. First and 10 from their own 26-yard line. Okay, the Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage. They got number 3, Braden Nowicki, wide receiver left. Looks like they're going to come out in their I formation, just waiting for the chain gang to get the chains set. First down before the ref can give the whistle to play. And yeah, it is a cold morning this morning. I'd be surprised if it's barely above freezing, but the sun coming out, it'll be good. So, all right. First and 10 for the Rockets. Let's see. Centrella calling the signal. The give is to, looks like number 8, Masciarelli, who trucks forward for about a 4-yard gain. On your offensive line, you've got number 71, Colin Donahue. Number 6, Giacomo Iapica. See who your guards are here in a minute. The give is to Masciarelli. Again, no yards. You've got number 50, Jason Anderson. Number, let's see, who else can we get in there? Number 21, Aiden Beckenhues would be one of your running backs. As the Rockets come off to the line, third down, about 5 yards to go for the first down. They need to get across the 38-yard line for the first. There's a pitch pass to Masciarelli, who's got some room on the outside. He breaks one tackle, and he's able to get the first down out of the run. So a nice hard run by Rocco Masciarelli, following his blockers around. To be able to pick up the first down. So we've got first and 10 for the Rockets. Also playing on the offensive line right now is number 72, Sean Murphy. Centrella gets under center. Gives the ball to 3, Braden Nowicki, who's making some nice quick moves across. He's got some yards. He's still running. Great job. I think my mouth is frozen here by Nowicki to pick up a nice first down run. Play was about a 60-yard run for Nowicki. Great job on the offensive line. Number 71, Donahue. Number 72, Murphy. Number 50, Anderson. Great job by those guys to give Nowicki a nice little hole right up the middle for a first down. No. Okay. Rockets looking to go in the end zone. And no way to go on that play. Number 70, Brady Swanson, is your center right now. As the Rockets will. Rockets come off to the line after no gain. They need a full 10 yards here to get the first down. They're at the Cowboy 18-yard line. The give is to Masciarelli, who's got some room up the middle. He trucks ahead for a few yards. About 4, maybe 5 on the carry. So it's going to be 3rd and 3. Got Nowicki wide left in a power eye formation. Centrella under center. He bobbles it a little bit. Ball goes to the ground, but he's quick enough to get his hands on it and just fall down. Save possession to bring up a big fourth down here. And about maybe 4 for the first. All right, we're in the red zone here, 4th and 4. Rockets looking to convert, keep the ball going. The give is to Mascherelli, who's got some room, and he plows ahead, and he gets in the end zone. Nice, nice hard run by Rocco Mascherelli to follow his lead blockers of number 6, Giacomo Iapica, Donahue, Anderson, Swanson. Just a great job. Aiden Beckenhuis right there to block as well. And the Rockets go in first down. You also had number 42, Vedant Narayan in there to help with the blocking as well. So the Rockets will go for the extra attempt. The ball is on the ground. A little cold out there today. So, I think that's having a little bit of an impact on the ball. But anyway, the attempt is no good. So the Rockets go up 6-0. All right, Rockets about to set kickoff. Number 6, Giacomo Iapica doing the honors here. Nice kick. Deep to the third level. And the Cowboy receiver just falls on the ground. So Rockets will go on defense at about the, Cowboy 35-yard line. Cowboys come up to the line of scrimmage. They're in what looks to be like a power eye. They give the handoff to the running back. He's got some room, and he's finally tackled by 21 Beckenhuis. 10 Centrella was in on the play. Donahue also there as well. So the Cowboys are able to get maybe about 9 yards on the play. So it's going to be 2nd and 1. They come out this time in, looks to be a little bit of a little trap play right there as the running back finds some room outside. Mascherelli in pursuit finally catches up with him to bring him down after a lengthy gain there by the Cowboys. They're inside of Rocket territory at the 28-yard line where they'll have it 1st and 10. All right, the Cowboys have a wing T formation here. Quarterback under center. They're going to give it to the running back again. In pursuit is Mascherelli, who makes a nice solo tackle right there on the play to hold the ball carrier for about maybe a 2-yard gain, as it'll be 2nd and about 7. Cowboys come up to the line of scrimmage, back in the T formation. The ball hit off. Donahue almost had him for a nice loss there, but the running back is able to scamper in on about a 25-yard touchdown run. So they tie up the game here, 6-6, as they go for the extra attempt. The Cowboys will try to kick here as it's blocked by the Rockets, and it looks like the ball was kept in play as somebody tried to advance it a little bit. Not sure if you can do that. Oh, it was actually caught behind the line, so incomplete. So we'd like to start with our first player profile of the game, and we're going to look at number 10, Eamon Santrella. He's been playing your quarterback the majority of this season, and Eamon is goes to Birch Middle School. His favorite food is chicken and broccoli with ziti's. That's a good one as well. I like that one. His favorite superhero is Captain America. When he's not playing football, he enjoys fishing. And when he grows up, he wants to be a chef or an owner of a restaurant. So hopefully someday he'll put together a nice place for us all to come out and eat. Maybe take a bunch of these guys on his team out to eat, makes him something nice. So the Rockets will return now. We've got number 7, Brendan Lindmark, and number 3, Braden Nowicki, back deep to return as the ref is about ready to give the whistle. Ready on the right, ready on the left, the Cowboys go. And we'll have kickoff here. So it's a good kick taken by number 8, Mascherelli. Brings it up to almost midfield at about the 49-yard line where the Rockets will take over 1st and 10. Okay, Rockets go on offense here. Looks like they're going to have number 8, Mascherelli, play quarterback this time as they've got a different defense in. He's going to keep it himself. He's got some room on the outside. He gets a great block by Donahue, but it looked like he might have got him in the back a little bit as there was a flag on the play. I got a feeling that's going to be a block in the back or a hold, so it looks like it's going to come back on the Rockets. Let's see what the ref says here. I don't know. They haven't really given a signal yet. Yeah, looks like it's going to be a block in the back for a 10-yard penalty. So it'll be Rockets will get the down over. It'll be 1st and 10. And with about 5 yards to go for the first down. Okay, the Rockets come back up to the line of scrimmage. They've got number 22, Jordan Whitmer, wide receiver left. And he's going to try to throw a nice block to help Mascherelli, who took the ball himself. And he gets about maybe a yard on the play. So we've got 2nd down, about 3 to go. Rockets come up on the line now. You've got number 80, Dylan Sweetser. As Mascherelli gives the ball to Beckham, who's got maybe looked to be like a false start on the play. We'll see here what the ref calls. You've also got number 54, Dylan Burpee, playing on the offensive line. As we mentioned, number 22 has been doing some, that's Jordan Whitmer, doing some good blocking at the wide receiver spot. Number 81, Zachary Galvin, is also out there to help out as the Rockets come 2nd and about 8, maybe, yeah, about 2nd and about 8 yards to go for the first down. They're on midfield, exactly the 50-yard line. The give is to Beckenhues, who's trying to truck ahead and get a few, and he does. After about 4 yards, it's 3rd down and maybe 5 to go. Oh, who's that? Is that like to, as we do every game, acknowledge the cheerleaders here doing a fine job. They're bundled up nice and cozy today, as they should be, because it's quite a cold one, as I've mentioned a million times. So thank you, girls. Good job today. So the Rockets, after the break for the quarter, we've got the 2nd quarter starting up now. The Rockets will get the ball. It's 3rd down and about 6 to go, as Mascherelli's going to keep it himself. He's got Whitmer out there trying to block for him. He makes a move, and he's got some room on the outside. And he's finally pushed out of bounds after a nice run of about a 25-yard pickup on that play. Following number 22, Whitmer, he also had number 7, Brendan Lindmark, out there. He also had Dylan Sweetser to help out, number 54. Dylan Burpee as well, and number 72, Sean Murphy. So great job by all the blockers to give Mascherelli enough room to pick up the first down and bring it inside the 20-yard line. So we got some red zone action here as the Rockets come back up to the line of scrimmage. Mascherelli is going to try to keep it himself. He's got a little bit of a hole, and he trucks ahead for about a 3-yard gain. Okay, here we go. See if the Rockets can punch it in here. They're on the Cowboy 10-yard line. And it looks like Beckenhuis is going to keep it this time. And he gets right close down to the end zone. He's got about maybe a yard to go for the touchdown. As it is going to be first down, so first and goal from maybe the two. All right, Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage looking to punch it in. And the ball is given. Oh, but it's a fumble on the play. Oh, that's a heartbreaker right there. They were driving. Unfortunately, the Cowboys are able to jump on the ball and create a little turnover there. So the Rockets now will go on defense. They're deep inside of Cowboy territory still. So see if they can hold them here. That cold weather continuing to play a little bit of havoc here as the players are having a tough time holding on to the ball as it's down on the ground again. But it looks like the Cowboys maintain possession. I believe they do. Yeah, so they do. So, boy, you know, we got to get some heaters here on the sideline or something. So it's going to be second down for the Cowboys, second and 10. Rockets are in their standard 5-3 defensive set. As the ball carrier goes up the middle for maybe about a yard on the gain. Big third down, 9.5 yards to go for the first. Rockets obviously trying to force a punt here. The ball carrier goes up the middle, but he's gonna be short. He got about 4 yards on the play, maybe five, because it's gonna be about third and five. So it's gonna be interesting to see what the coach is gonna call here for the Cowboys. Whether or not he's going to punt it away or just try to get the first down. I'm not sure what kind of a punter they do have. But regardless, it's a big play here as they come up to the line of scrimmage. And don't know if they're going to. Got a little bit of an equipment issue there on the side. But looks like they're going to try to go for it here. As the quarterback gives it to the running back, and number 33, Carter Leonard, makes an excellent play on the cornerback position to stop the ball carrier and create a turnover as the ball will go back into the Rockets' hands, first and 10. Yep. All right, here we go, first down. They're on the Cowboy 15-yard line, maybe 14. Centrella under center. He's going to give the ball to Muscarelli, who's wrapped up immediately for no gain on the play. Okay, the Rockets try it again here. In the power eye formation. Centrella under center. Ball's bobbled a little bit at the line of scrimmage, and it looks like the Cowboys dove on it. Wow, so that ball has been on the ground probably three times in the past 5 minutes as either team is having a real tough time holding on to it. So the Rockets are going to go on defense now as the Cowboys take over first and 10. Got number 33, Connor Lurden, to your close side cornerback. Number 10, Centrella, playing safety, slips over. They've got two receivers set. Cowboys keep it. It looks like there was a little bit of a pitch pass there as the running back gets about 4 yards on the play. Okay, let's see if the Rockets obviously can hold him here. It's quarterback. He's going to go deep. He's got a man wide open as that was a nice play by the Cowboys. Finally, number 80, Dylan Sweetser, is able to stop him. Looked like there was a fumble on the play, but the refs are saying that the ground caused the ball to come up, which does not make it a fumble. So Cowboys get a first down. All right, our next player profile, we're going to look at number 8, Rocco Muscarelli. And Rocco has been doing an excellent job this year, both at quarterback position, running the ball, on the defense. I mean, his kid's been all over the place this year. So his nickname, they call him Little Mush. He is a sixth grader at the Parker Middle School by way of Joshua Eaton. His favorite food is tacos, and his favorite superhero is Thor. When Rocco is not playing football, he loves to ski. He's a great downhill skier up in New Hampshire. And when he grows up, he wants to be a graphic designer. Looks like following his mom's footsteps a little bit there. So, Cowboy, that's Rocco Muscarelli, number 8, Rocco Muscarelli. The Cowboys take over after the first down. There's a flag on the play. And it's going to be a holding against the Cowboys. So it's going to back them up 10 yards and remain first down. Okay, after the holding penalty, the Cowboys are at their own 35-yard line. They've got first and 20. Oh, a little bit of movement on the line. Wasn't called. Number 50, Jason Anderson, was able to get back into the backfield and really make a great play back there to stop the running back. Looks like we've got a timeout on the field, and I believe that timeout is taken by the Cowboys. All right, after the timeout, we come back to the action here on the field. The quarterback for Cowboys is going to keep it himself. He's got a little bit of room up. He's got a little bit of room up the middle. There's some confusion out there, as it looks like the ball might be on the ground again. And we'll wait to see what the ref says. No, it's going to remain the Cowboys' ball. So the Rockets now will take a timeout. Third down. About 18 yards to go for the first, as there's a little bit of movement on the play. Looks like the Rockets might have been offsides. And looks like that is going to be the case, as the ref will further the ball 5 yards forward in favor of the Cowboys. It'll remain third down. Third down and about 12 to go for the first down. As the Rockets looking to stop them. Cowboys come up to the line of scrimmage in the I formation. There's the handoff to the tailback. And he gets about 7 yards on the play. So after that carry, it's going to be fourth down and about 5 yards to go. Ball right at midfield. So we'll see what the Cowboys do. We've got about 2 minutes left here in the first half. And fourth down, 5 yards to go. It's a trap play to the fullback. He's trying to get outside. Lerner's in pursuit. And he's finally pushed out of bounds by Centrella, Donahue, Muscarelli, Sweetser, but it was after he was able to get the first down. So the Cowboys maintained possession inside of the Rockets' territory, first and 10. All right. Cowboys come back up to the line of scrimmage in the I formation. The give is going to be to the fullback. Number 40, Jack Janes, did a great job of plugging the hole, but the running back, wow, he was able to bounce outside and make a quick juke right, and he was able to break free and get into the end zone. So that's a touchdown for the Cowboys, as they now go up 12-6. We know that pole there is in the way, unfortunately, so try to describe it as best I can here. The extra attempt, the give is to the fullback right up the middle, but it's stopped by the Reading defensive line. So great job in not allowing the extra point, as the Rockets hold them to a 12-6 score. All right, the Rockets are set to return. Number 7, Lindmark. Number 3, Nowicki, back deep. The ball is bouncing around down there a little bit. It's finally a little bit of confusion there. It's finally jumped on by number 23. Michael Olson, and the Rockets are going to have it first down. They're right about their own 40-yard line. All right, with about a minute 20 left in the half, Rockets going to take over first down. Want to try to get in the end zone here as they're going to try to pass it. And, oh, boy, great attempt. Mascherelli had a nice spin on that ball, tried to get it out to Beckenhuis, who was open, but it was just a little bit overthrown. So it's going to bring up second down. Rockets try again. Mascherelli, looks like they're going to try to throw it again, but he's going to keep it himself. We do have a whistle on the play. I'm not sure if we had a penalty or if maybe somebody called a timeout there. You see what happened there, John? I don't know. Okay, it was. No, actually, it looks like we had a penalty. Looks like it was a false start against the Rockets. I was going to back them up 5 yards, keeping it second down. All right, they got about 15 yards to go here for the first down. Mascherelli's going to try to, he's got some room on the outside. He was going to try to pass it, but he tucked it down, kept it himself as he saw a little bit of a lane there, but filled it quickly as they get about 5 yards on the play. It's going to be third down and about five to go after the time. Got a timeout on the field. All right, the Rockets come up. Beckenhuis, wide receiver right. He gives it a little pass to Donahue, trucks somebody, and he's finally brought down. But he did get enough of the first down. As it'll move the chains, looks like the Rockets are going to stay in a hurry up. This can't be more than, it might be 50 seconds left on the play. And it looks like they may try to spike the ball here just to stop it as they get up. I think we have a timeout. Looks like we got a timeout. Maybe the Cowboys. I don't understand that one there, but it is what it is. So timeout. We got a two receiver set, split right, Mascherelli, and the ball is down on the ground. Centrell is trying to chase it back there. He finally was able to pounce on the ball. So a smart move, but no, it looks like it's a fumble on the play. Yeah, it looks like it's a fumble on the play as the Cowboys take over. Wow. So unfortunate break there for the Rockets as they're going to have to go and play defense now and obviously try not to let one slip in here for the Cowboys before the half. All right, so the Rockets come out on defense. The ball is pitched. They're going to try to pass it here. They've got a man wide open, and he catches it, but the ball's on the ground again. And the Rockets take over. Wow, man, oh, man, this is going to be the turnover bowl here. That's what we're gonna label this game. I mean, this is insane. I don't know about any air pressure issues here with these balls, but it certainly is it's hard for the Rockets and the Cowboys to hold on to it, so... Fortunate break this time for the Rockets as they get the ball back. Probably about 30 seconds left in the half. Mascherelli at center. The ball is given at quarterback, but the ball is given to Santrella, who launches it, and it's picked off. It's picked off by the Cowboys. Uh-oh, this kid's got some room along the outside. I don't see any flags on the play. He's going to go in for a touchdown. Man, oh, man, what a crazy episode is going on here. Turnovers, interceptions, drop balls. And unfortunately, it goes in favor of the Cowboys as they go in for the touchdown. So Northern Middlesex goes up by another 6 as the score right now. 18 Cowboys, 6 Rockets as they will try for the extra attempt. All right, we've got that pole issue again, so I'll just do my best to describe the play, which is a handoff to the running back who's going outside, and he's able to put his shoulder down and go across the goal line for the extra attempt. That's going to make the score, 19-6, Cowboys. All right, so that was the end of the first half. As I mentioned, the score right now, 19-6, Cowboys. We'll see if Coach Swanson and staff can get this crew fired up and come back to play a much better second half. So we'll see you when we come back. All right, as we start second half action here, the Rockets will be kicking off. Number 6, Giacomo Iapica, doing the duties as usual. And it's a nice kick. Yeah, it goes right to the second level of North Middlesex. Bounces off the receive man, but he's able to fall on it. So let's see what we can get out of this Rocket squad here in the second half. Down by 2 touchdowns. And they will come out on defense. All right, the Cowboys come up to the line of scrimmage. They're on their own 37-yard line. It's first and 10. The ball's on the ground again. Go figure. But the Rockets, nope, the Cowboys are able to jump on it. Lost about 2 yards on the play. Okay, the Cowboys come up to the line of scrimmage in the T formation. They're going to try to pass it here. They had a man open, but the Rocket defense, led there by number 50, Jason Anderson, assisted by number 80, Dylan Sweetser, number 51, Ryan Bonacci, number 23, Michael Olson, came in and did an excellent job to stop the play. So it's going to be third down, 12 yards to go. We've got number 7, Brendan Lindmark, playing safety. Number 6, Giacomo Iapica, playing corner. Number 33, Carter Learned, playing corner. Excuse me. The ball carry goes up the field. He's tackled by number 7. He's tripped up by number 7, Brendan Lindmark, to allow for the rest of the team to get there. And it's going to be a big fourth down here. It's fourth down in about a yard and a half, maybe a short 2, rather, for the first down for the Cowboys. So let's see if this Rocket defense can hold them here. As they come out, the Cowboys come out in this T formation, quarterback under center. The give is to the running back, who trucks ahead and gets enough for the first down. So that's going to be enough to move the chains, as the ball is just short of midfield at the 48-yard line. Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage. They've got number 40, Jack James, playing at linebacker right now, along with Beckham Hughes and Mascherelli. The give is to the tailback. The ball's on the ground again. And number 21, Aiden Beckham Hughes, this time comes up with it. So Rockets got a nice little break there as they're going to take over on first down. Rockets come off to the line of scrimmage. They got number 22, Jordan Whitmer, split wide right. Number 8, Mascherelli at quarterback. Looks like they one man short, as number 81, Zachary Galvin, comes in on the line. And Mascherelli is going to keep it himself. He's got some blocking there by Donahue. And he's trucking ahead, holding on to that ball tight. Good job. We've got those slippery balls going today, so nice job by Mascherelli to hold on to it and bring about 4 or 5 defenders with him as he gets the first down. First and 10, Rockets. To the line of scrimmage here, number 23, Michael Olson on the line with number 70, Brady Swanson. Mascherelli's going to try to keep it again. He's got a little bit of hole. That line was given by the offensive line. Mascherelli does some nice running hard again. He gets about 9 yards on the play. As they truck further towards the end zone, it's going to be second and about 2. Got Rockets come back up to the line of scrimmage. Whitmer this time wide left, as Mascherelli will again keep the ball. And that time, unfortunately, he was wrapped up behind the line of scrimmage, so no gain on the play, as it will remain third down. All right, Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage, trying to get that first down to keep the drive alive. The quarterback is Mascherelli, who's going to keep it this time. He's got a nice hole there as he does a nice job of holding on to the ball as the defenders there were trying to rip that thing out. They think they can get that ball on the ground a couple times. So first down, Rockets. Okay, first down. Rockets are at the 20-yard line, 19-yard line of the Cowboys. Mascherelli's going to try to keep it himself again. Gets a nice block out there by Whitmer, but it was filled quickly as the Rockets get a couple more yards out of the play. It's going to be second down and about six to go. Okay. Rockets come out with number 71, Donahue. In the Moose formation, the ball's on the ground as looked like Centrella was playing quarterback, I believe. No, maybe it was Whitmer. It might have been 22 Whitmer on the play. So big third down here, third and about eight to go. All right, Rockets come back up to the line of scrimmage, trying desperately to punch that ball into the end zone. Mascherelli, he's going to try to pass it. Oh, no. Looked like it was an incomplete pass. Looks like his momentum was going forward. So no fumble on the play as Rockets maintain possession. But now they've got a big fourth down here. They've got to get about the 8-yard line to get the first. They're at about the 17, the 16, a 17. Mascherelli under center. He's got Whitmer wide right. He's going to try to keep it himself. He's got some room to the outside. And it doesn't look like he's going to be able to get the first down as the refs. Yeah, it's going to be the call. So we're going to look at number 7. Brendan Lindmark, our last player profile of the game. Brendan, whose nickname is Brenny, is a fifth grader at the Barrows Elementary School, and his favorite food is cheese pizza, and his favorite superhero is Spider-Man, that's just like his dad, and when he's not playing football, he enjoys practicing other sports, and when he grows up, like most kids, he wants to be a professional football player. So that's my son, number 7, Brendan Lindmark. So the Rockets play defense here as Jack James comes in to help out. And the Cowboys might have got a yard on the play, maybe two. So it's going to bring up second down. Okay, Rockets come back up. Excuse me, the Cowboys come back up to the line of scrimmage. This time they're back into their I formation, going away from the T. Uh-oh, got a little bit of movement on the line. And, looked like the Rockets may have jumped there as the ref did throw the flag. So it's going to be 5 yards in favor of the Cowboys. Okay, second down, about 4 yards to go for the first. Rockets desperately want to stop him on this drive. Quarterback keeps himself, chugs ahead. Boy, the whole pile is moving there. Let's see if the ball's on the ground again. It might be. No, it's not. But it is enough for a first down in favor of the Cowboys. So they're going to go first and 10 from their own 25. All right, let's go defense. Let's go defense. Cowboys in the eye. Pitch pass to the tailback back off the right-hand side. He's got some room. Gets about 6 yards on the play as he followed his blockers. Finally, looks like number 10, Centrella. Number 3, Nowicki. Number 23, Olsen were all there to make the play. Okay, as we start the fourth quarter, the score is 19. Cowboys, 6 Rockets. Quarterback here is scrambling. And he goes down after about maybe a yard on the play. And it's going to bring up third down and about two to go for the Rock, for the Cowboys. Okay. Cowboys come up to the line of scrimmage. They are in the, looks like the I formation. They're going with the quarterback sneak again. This is where the fumbles can happen. And I think it's going to be fourth down here. I don't think they got the first. I think we're going to have a real big fourth down. They may have to bring out the chains here on this one. No, the ref is giving it to him. Oh, that's a move the chains. So first down for the Cowboys. Okay, as evidenced by this entire game, the ball is slippery, cold and slippery. The Rockets desperately need a turnover here, down two touchdowns. One guy wraps, two guys wrap, another guy goes for the ball. Maybe an opportunity here as the quarterback, excuse me, the running back, finds some room on the outside. He gets a few on that play. He's going to get about 8 yards on the play, so going to be second and about two. Cowboys come up to the line of scrimmage in a very tight formation. Looks like they might try that QB sneak again. Nope, they're going to try a quick little pass. But number 50, Anderson, is not fooled as he gets back there and makes a great play. Finally, Muscarelli, Iapica, Galvin, and Centrella were able to stop him. Looks like we've got an injury timeout on the field. After the injury timeout, looks like the young fellow was okay. Cowboys have it first and 10. They're at their own 45-yard line. Rockets desperately looking for a turnover here as the running back goes up the yard, up the gut for about 2 yards on the play. We need to get the strip that ball chant going here, John. Strip that ball. second and 10. Second. All right, see what the Rockets can do here to stop them. The give is to the running back who gets about a yard on the play, so it's gonna bring up third and about five, third and about six. So this is really a big series here for the Rockets. I mean, they're down by two touchdowns right now. We're in fourth quarter. And the Cowboys are going to continue just to move the ball on the ground to chew up that clock, one would assume. So with about 6 yards to go here for the first, obviously the Rockets are going to try to hold them. So very crucial series right here. Quarterback is under center. He's going to give the ball to the fullback. As that seems to be the strategy here, they're just going to keep the ball right in the middle, just give it up the gut, and see what they can chew out of here. So now you got a very interesting down, fourth down, 1 yard to go. As this is going to be an interesting call here, what the Cowboys are going to do. I mean, I'm thinking they're going right up the middle. I'm putting everybody right on the nose and basically plugging that hole right up the middle, but yeah, it looks like they're ready. Centrella's up there close. So isn't Beckenhue, so isn't Muscarelli. They're expecting the QB sneak, and they stopped him. They stopped him, so the Rockets are able to get the ball back. They read that play well. They knew it was coming. They got in there, and they stopped them to give themselves an opportunity here. So the Rockets take over on downs, first and 10 from their own 45. Right. Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage. Try to punch it in here. They're in their power eye formation with Centrella under center. And the give is going to be to Nowicki, who gets another 8 or 9 yards on the play. I mean, every time that kid number three touches the ball, he's going to get about 7 or 8 yards. I mean, that's probably his average. So, if it's working, stick with it. Second down, 3 yards to go for the first. And they're bringing Nowicki out wide this time. Centrella's up under center. Beckenhuis and Muschiarelli in the backfield. The ball is going to be given to Muschiarelli, who's got some room on the outside. And he's got some room if he can beat this last defender, which he can. All right. So great job by the offensive line to give Muschiarelli a hole there. And he took advantage of it right when he got through the hole. I mean, he turned on the jets and just took it to the outside and rushed in for about 45 yards on the play. So that was the break that the Rockets needed right there. Very, very excellent job by the entire team as the Rockets put six more on the board. And, you know, they got a very big extra point here right now because the Cowboys were able to convert one. So really, the Rockets do need to convert this extra point. As they come up to the line of scrimmage, they've got Centrella under center, Beckenhuis, Muschiarelli in the backfield, standard I formation. And they're just gonna try to punch it right in here by giving it to Muschiarelli, but he's met immediately. Actually, a really great defensive play there by the Cowboy defensive lineman, as he met Muschiarelli right at the line of scrimmage there. So the extra point attempt is no good, but the Rockets are able to put six more on the board, making the score Cowboys 19, Rockets 12. All right, the Rockets are going to come up to the line of scrimmage. Get ready for the kickoff here. Now, the call is, do you go deep or do they go for the onside? They've converted an onside before once, and it looks like Iapika might be trying for this onside kick, although they're calling ready on the left, ready on the right, ready on the left. He does. He goes for the onsides. Ball is bouncing down there. And the Cowboys were able to hang on to it. So I like the attempt. Very exciting. The Rockets will go on defense, try to stop him here. There's probably about 5 minutes left in the game as we have an injury on the field. All right. Number 21, Aiden Beckenhuis, a little banged up on the play there, but he's able to walk off the field under his own power, so that's good to see. He's a tough kid, and I'm sure he'll be fine. So Rockets play defense. Number 50, Anderson, is able to get into the field. We got a flag on the play. We got a hold. Yep, got a hold against the offense, so. Got a hold against the offense, and we got an injury on the field. No, I'm sorry. There was a hold on the penalty. I'm gonna back the Cowboys up 10 yards, and it's going to remain first down, about 20 yards to go for the first down. The Cowboys are at their own 42-yard line. As Rockets are obviously going to try to stop them here. The straight eye formation. The give is to the running back who's met after about a 5 yard gain on the play, and it's gonna be timeout Rockets. Okay. After the timeout, we got second down, 11 yards to go. The give is to the fullback up the middle, gets about a yard on the play. And I think we got another timeout on the field. Yeah, looks like we got another timeout. Looks like Redding. What do we got here? We got third down. Third down and 9 yards to go. The ground is on the ball. The ball is on the ground. I got excited there. And I just don't know if it's going to be. Okay, so we just heard there's 2 minutes, 45 seconds left in the game. It's fourth down for the Cowboys. Fourth and about 10. So after the timeout, we're going to have a very, very big and interesting play. Give it. Yeah. Okay. This could be a ball game here. We got a big fourth down, 10 yards to go for the Cowboys. They're going to punt it. Wow. All right. And that ball gets a good little bounce on it. Beckin Hughes. He's trying to make some moves out there. So the Rockets take over on downs. They've got about 85 yards to go here for the touchdown, which is where they need to be. Again, the score, 19 Cowboys, 12 for the Rockets. So even if they do score, they have to get the extra attempt in order just to tie the game. So let's see what happens. It's about maybe 2 minutes and 40 seconds left in the game. Rockets come up. And Nowicki, give the ball to Nowicki. But he's met by the Cowboy defense after about a yard gain on the play. Rockets are in the hurry up. They have to be. Time is working against them, but they look smooth. They look smooth. They just got to keep moving that ball out. As the pitch is to Masciarelli. And he's met after about a three-yard gain on the play. 1:50 left in the game. The refs are announcing third down. About 7 yards to go for the first. So this is no doubt a huge, huge series right here. As the Rockets will come up to the line of scrimmage. They've got Centrella in the shotgun. Nope, Masciarelli, excuse me, in the shotgun. The give is to Masciarelli. He's trying to get outside, but he's met at the line of scrimmage. Good hard run. He loses about a yard on the play, so it's going to bring up fourth down. A huge fourth down. And nine to go. As I don't believe Coach Swanson has any more timeouts, because I would have thought he would have used it at this point. So Rockets are just trying to get set here. As they got the two wide receiver set, they got Masciarelli and Beckin Hughes to the left. Centrella, fourth and nine. He's running, and he's tackled behind the line of scrimmage by the Cowboy defenseman, as North Middlesex will take over on downs. That was an unfortunate break there. The Rockets had the momentum. They had everything going, but just didn't work out on that one. So Rockets take over, excuse me, Cowboys take over, first and 10, and they're at the Rocket 7 yard line. Well, that's the game, folks. Thought they were gonna be able to have one more play there to run, but no, that is the game. So the Rockets really played a very, very good football game today. I mean, a lot of fumbles, both teams. Very evenly matched squads. The Rockets just come away from this one a little bit on the short end side, as the final score is 19 North Middlesex, 12 for the Rockets. But once again, they have they played a very good game. They have a lot to be proud of, and they're going to go into Acton-Boxborough next weekend with their heads high and ready to go. So we'll see you next week from Acton-Boxborough.